looking for the next wave of breakthrough technology. Are you doing that? You know, we had so many things, but this is going to frighten you. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to talk about the HoloLens experience. Please welcome a gentleman who goes by the name Aman Suyo. He's transformation lead from Microsoft. Aman, come on, get on stage. Hey.
Thank you for the introduction. Great to meet you.
Talking about that HoloLens, is it like, you know, somebody in New Zealand could actually see me on this very stage wearing sneakers? Is it something like that? You know, I'm just a journalist, just a guy.
It can be much more.
Much more?
Much more, yes.
The but place is all yours.
Thank you. So, some of you will ask yourself, what does a transformation lead do at Microsoft? I hear that question very often, and I said, I'm one of the few people who can do what he really wants to. And in this case, I talk a lot with customers about digital transformation and the business opportunities we have with us together in the market. I want to discuss with you in the next 45 minutes a bit of how can Microsoft help you transform your ideas to reality. And I think that's the main thing. And in the last 2 days, I heard a lot of cool technologies and solutions. And what I want to show you in the next 45 minutes is what is the Microsoft game and how can we really help you being successful in the market. I want to start not with HoloLens. I want to start with another device. Hopefully everybody of you know of or is aware of. It's a special device. You can see it here down. And with that device, it's called Surface Hub. This is a 48-inch display. It's built from Microsoft for the meeting room. And at that point, I want to introduce a special guest for me, and Tobias Enders. Tobias, hello.
Hello. Hi, Amo.
In 2 minutes, just tell me who you are.
Yeah, my name is Tobias Enders. I'm CEO of GMS Global Media Services.
What does your company do?
GMS is focused on AV media technology for meeting rooms, especially for enterprise customers.
What was your experience with Microsoft? How did you come to Microsoft?
Well, before we started working with Microsoft, I think 12 months ago, I thought Microsoft is Windows and Office. Today, I'm very happy to stand here with you, Amor. Our company now is a Microsoft Gold partner. The Surface Hub actually is one of our top-selling products, and our company is now using the full set of Microsoft portfolio, including Office 365, including Azure Cloud Services, and Dynamics CRM.
Just tell me, what is the special thing about Surface Hub? Very quick.
The meeting room technology is facing a lot of transformation and change, and the Surface Hub is actually the first device that I saw that helps the customer to have an IT enterprise-ready meeting room device. The experience is very, very powerful, and it's very helpful for large organizations to handle their meeting room environment.
Are there any other situations where you can use the Surface Hub?
I think the best scenario is that it's not just a piece of hardware, but it's a cloud device where you can access your data, where you can access information that you need. You don't need necessarily to connect any third-party devices to the Surface Hub, so it's already there, and it's a very nice and powerful solution.
Okay, thank you at that point, Tobias. You will come later again and tell another story. And between that, I will tell you a little bit of what Microsoft makes a difference. And in the end, you know, we see a lot of technologies coming up on each side of our daily life. But in the end, it's very important to make a business model out of it and really use that technology to go further. And at that page, I want to tell you some secrets, what Microsoft really differentiates maybe from others, and how our culture was changed. We heard from Tobias that a lot of people think Microsoft is Office and Windows. We have a totally change in the last 3 years from our portfolio. And at some points, we can really show that where we really thought about, okay, we looked at technologies like Linux, and it was very hard for us to really deal with that, because we didn't understand that. What means a community and what means open, to be open, and how to deal with a community like this. Today, you can see that at three points. First, a lot of tool sets we put open source, for example, PowerShell and others. Today, SQL Server runs on Azure, on Linux, which is, I think, amazing. And our openness is in very different areas. You can see that we are open, and we love Linux. That was, in the past, a totally different story. And today, we look totally different on our competitors. In the past, maybe, we really wanted to push them out of the market. Today, we said, OK, you have a cool technology. And that's a reason for us to be more innovative. And that's a cultural change we made. And with this cultural change, we got really fast and agile. For a big company as Microsoft, it's not very easy to be agile and dynamic. So if you look to these two girls here on the slide, you said, OK, my mobile is important to me. Who would say that here in the room? OK, nearly everybody, my mobile is important, right? OK, if I should ask, why is it important? What does it do for you? Maybe the answer would be, I can go shopping everywhere, right? I can order a taxi, I can chat with my friends and stuff like that. Who would say these are the main reasons? Nearly, and you have apps and stuff like that. In the end, it comes up with an app economy. But what there was done is you put something from the web to an app, because you can use it everywhere then. And we think that this is not the end of the story. And what we are thinking is that we have a lot of services built in our software. And I will give you an example everybody should know, because we have friends who don't speak the language yourself speak.
Can you understand me now, Xiangbin?
你现在能理解我吗?
你会讲中文啦!
He, you speak Chinese.
So what we have here is a translation service built into Skype. But this service is not only built in Skype. You can use this as an API with our cloud platform. So the thing is, if you want to know what the girl is answering, you just use our translation service. There's a story behind this that we have our services built into our products, but as well we give you the possibility to build your own applications to use the service as an API. It's just like building blocks. And to show you something, which services we really can serve to you, I just go through some of the APIs we have in our cloud platform. And most of them I saw in the last 2 days where somebody has a service behind that. But we can deliver these as an API. You can see here we have a picture analysis. And from this picture, you send that to our service. The service gives you back, OK, what is the gender? What is the age of the person? What is the adult score? And stuff like that. So we have that built in ready as an API. You just can use that as your in your own application, or you can just use it as your service. I think it was half an hour ago we saw something about emotions, right? OK. We have emotions as well. We can analyze them as well. Is that person happy? Is that person not happy? How is the willingness to buy, maybe, or something like that? You just put it to the service, the picture, or in real time, and you get back all that information from the service with a JSON file, for example. You can use other services as well, as the language understanding, the translation service, etc., because we can help you build up these right in with your application to really get up to speed. Okay, so the thing is, what we do here with our services is to really bring you in the situation that you can very fast build your own applications from the Bing speech, speaker recognition, so you can really set, okay, what is that person speaking? Is that person A? Is that person B? You can see the language, linguistic analytics, academic knowledge, so where you can use databases and backend, or our Bing services, which are right built in into our service. So you can use them as an API. And what we think is that we already left the app economy, and we are moving right forward to an API economy, which will be the future of understanding. To see out the power of our platform, you can think about, okay, everybody knows the situation that you say, okay, you need help because you want to spend not so much resources, and you need process automation, because behind the data center automation, there comes a process automation. And with this process automation, you see that we implemented a bot framework where you can really, like a kind of Lego, connect your things together. And we built that into our products on the one hand, but as well on the other hand, we said, okay, you have an API where you can use the bot service right into your application. Here is an example where we made a bot where you can order a pizza with Pizza Hut. With Skyscanner, you can book a flight. You can try that out direct after the session here. Now it comes together, okay, how can we connect all these things? And what is the game of HoloLens? With HoloLens, I would bring that live here on stage so everybody could see that. But this was not possible because the cameras, there are special cameras needed to bring that hologram here on the stage. And so what we did is, okay, we have the HoloLens here. What I can offer is, I will say three questions of some of the content here, and what I can offer is that three persons behind can have a 5-minute session on the HoloLens. The reason why I can't put that here is because the cameras didn't come here, and they are very complex to build a hologram so everybody can see that. So how is our story to connect all these services, and how easy you can bring value into your solution? So you see, on the one hand, you have these powerful APIs, which analyzes pictures, languages, texts, etc. And on the other hand, you have this Internet of Things stuff. And now imagine that you have the bots not only talking persons to machines, but machines to machines, and integrate all this stuff with the Internet of Things. So what is our story? How do we understand this complex things of Internet of Things? So what we do is, what we say is, okay, there are some devices out there, which can be a production machine, which can be a HoloLens, which can be a Raspberry Pi, which can be any device out there. And how can I connect that to the cloud with a very complex scenario? So with our Azure IoT Suite, you just say, OK, this is the solution name. Choose your region where you want to deploy that. And you said, OK, create the solution. And all the stuff behind is done automatically. So you can start projects like predictive maintenance. And this is all automated, done with our cloud platform in the back end. So what is the result behind? So you want to have your portal where you have your Internet of Things, which means devices, you have rules. What should happen if this happens with the device? What should be the action behind? So if that happens, then do that. And now you can imagine how you can bring all this stuff together from bots, from ready services to Internet of Things devices, and how you can connect all these things. And if you think a little bit further, if you have CRM systems and connect that with your customers, you can automate a lot of processes behind and integrate that all together. And you can integrate all other solutions as well, because it's an open platform. So at one time, you must think about, OK, what is really the value and what brings me really value? It's not a single end-to-end solution. You have all your data, all your solutions already, and it seems to be good to integrate them. And as I mentioned before, it's very easy if you have Azure-certified devices. It's just one click. And if you say, OK, this is not an Azure-certified device, it's not a problem. But you can find the code on GitHub. So as I said before, Microsoft is an open company. And our thing is that we said, OK, we have ready solutions built in software. We have a lot of services built in our Azure Cloud platform. And we have individual services where you can put your algorithms with machine learning. So you can do all that in one platform. And I think this is very valuable. On the Boot HMI, we showed something. We had 70 customers. We showed with how groups on a global level manage the elevators with predictive analytics. We have Rolls-Royce. We have solutions with Liebherr, where we manage all these bridges. At IFA, we presented something like that. So this is very interesting. So on the one hand, it's possible to connect all this stuff in one platform, connect all these services and solutions. Some of them you have seen here. But in the end, you have to bring in some intelligence in all this data. It's not only about reporting. But first of all, you have to make it intelligent. And we have the tool there built into the platform. And in the last, you have to make it visible. And for that, we have a very powerful tool, which is Power BI. So it's very easy. And that's our view of the future, where we said, OK, hey, look at this. It's very easy to have from an idea to reality. We have a tool set. And from the start point you have, you can go right into that. So you have seen now a dashboard. I don't want to go through that dashboard. But what I want to show is it's very easy to integrate services from other SaaS services directly into this platform. So you just choose your data source and integrate that in the visualization tool and connect that with your service. So this is our idea and how easy it should be to bring all these data together, bring intelligence in it, use ready solutions, use very individual solutions, own algorithms, and stuff like that, integrate that all together in a very powerful visualization. So that is our story behind our cloud platform. And I think that is far away from Office and Windows, you maybe know from the past. With the HoloLens, we did something special, and we really differentiate there from others, which not means that we think the virtual reality tools from the others are not the right way. They are very powerful, they are very cool, and on the Windows platform, we integrate a virtual reality stack, so everything is can run on our Windows platform. But what the other do is, you have the virtual reality, or you have the reality. What we do with HoloLens is totally different. We have built in three Kinect cameras. These three Kinect cameras screen the room with 1 millimeter accuracy. So they know exactly where you are, what is this 3D model from the room. And we have some holograms directly built into the reality. So we have a mixed reality. And this is very special. And I just want to give you an overview of what HoloLens is.
Look around. Technology is all around us. We use it in every aspect of our lives. It enables us to do amazing things. But what if we could go further? What if we could go beyond the screen? Where your digital world is blended with your real world. Now we can. This is the world with holograms. What will they enable us to do? New ways to visualize our work.
You know, I have an idea for the fuel tank.
New ways to share ideas with each other.
How are things going your end?
I just put the images in OneDrive.
Perfect.
More immersive ways to play. New ways to teach and learn.
So put the new trap in the place of the old one.
Now what?
And tighten here and here.
New ways to collaborate and explore the places we've never been.
Look at this formation. Let's take a closer look.
And new ways to create the things we imagine. Because when you change the way you see the world, you can change the world you see. This is Microsoft HoloLens.
So what you have seen is that HoloLens really mixed this virtual reality with normal reality. And all applications, Windows Universal apps, most of them run on HoloLens. You can now already go to the Microsoft Store and look which applications run on HoloLens. And it's very exciting to see, okay, how that builds directly into the normal view you have. So you have really cool business opportunity behind that from a business perspective. And you can discuss that with some partners we have here. I will come to that later. Bernd will your person at that way. But it's not only the thing having HoloLens, all this data, and having all this intelligence behind. There's something coming up in the next future, which means quantum computer. And this is very exciting, because Microsoft looks at this very special. And here you can see at Microsoft Research, nearly 15% of our revenue goes directly back to research and development. And you can see here, these are all projects with quantum computers. And one funny thing behind is that the first project we started was 2003. So what is a quantum computer? A normal computer can have a bit, which means it's 0 or 1. A quantum computer has both. So it can be 0 or it can be 1. So this is, you don't have a linear capacity growth. You have an exponential growth. So once that is built up, we have total new capacity in the market. So Microsoft thinks that it's very important to give everybody access to these resources in future. So at this point, I told you I want to bring Tobias back again on stage. Tobias, you started 1 year ago.
Yeah, we started approximately 1 year ago.
Come up.
And today I stand here, and as I said, our business is focused on hardware and focused on services. But today we are in the process setting up a new company focused on software development. And we developed a software that organizes the whole meeting process. And this is really powerful and very helpful for the majority of my customers. So with the help of Microsoft and with the experience that we have in our company, we managed a lot of transformation. And this is really important to the success of our future business. So I'm happy to be here with Microsoft. I'm very excited about our partnership. And I really can encourage everyone here to speak to Microsoft to see how Microsoft can help transform your business. This is really key to success for the future from my perspective.
So when I understand that right, you start talking with, you're coming out of a hardware business, start talking with Microsoft. You thought about, okay, what can this device make more powerful, and used some of the technology I presented today to build up a software which really can help your customer fixing their problems, their process problems. Is that right?
Exactly. From a hardware-driven business, we saw the full toolkit that you presented, predictive services, analytics, and we included this into the new software tool, and this is really powerful to our future business.
Okay, thank you. So you can see how easy it is. And they started developing the software solution 9 months ago. And they have now the first customers on the tool set. And that's very interesting to see how, if you go to building blocks and deliver fixed APIs and services, it's very easy to integrate that. So in the end, what I want to say is, I think we have the technology, the devices, the platform, the openness to competitors to integrate all that. And I think it's very interesting to think not an end-to-end solution, but think what you have and how can we help making your ideas more powerful and bring that really fast time to market. So just an offer from my side. If you have some questions regarding the things to Tobias, which means to Surface Hub, or to the application they build it. The other thing is, if you have some questions about all this IoT stuff you saw, we have a partner here, which is Danet. They have some HoloLenses. So if you want to start HoloLens projects, this is the right partner. They have 6 HoloLenses. So they can really help you bring in the first projects to market. And I think, if we think about that together with this whole stuff Microsoft brings or serves to you, you have to deal with Microsoft, but together we can bring your ideas to reality. And I promise that at least 3 of you will get a HoloLens 5-minute session now here on the booth. All others need to go to the Danet afterwards. I have a question. What is the name of the cloud platform where you can connect all these things? It's on the slide. I didn't say it. Azure, who was it? First. Okay, cool. What do we think is coming behind the app economy? Right? So we have the second person. And how many Kinect cameras are built into the HoloLens? 3? Okay, so we have our third person. So I really would love to see HoloLens here on stage for everybody, but this is not possible, as I told you before. I thank you so much for your time, and hope to see you next year.